Welcome back to Let's Play A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Luritari. I remember a now loading thing happening with that. When we go into the town. Anyway, we're going around talking to everybody again. Hopefully this will be the last time. Oh, you're the lazy guy. Other adventurers headed for the strongholds of the Dark Power or fighting monsters along the highways. I'm lying down here to store up energy in case something should happen to Valkd. I'm hoping, really, that everyone will return safely. Sighing and rolling over. Yeah, huh? Everyone's gone to fight. I'm very worried. But sitting here worrying doesn't solve the problem. I'll make some tea and wait for their safe return. Following Douglas, Ramona, and Blade also left Valkd with the volunteer soldiers. Bardas, please protect them with your blessings. Well, we are not Bardas. So why the hell are you saying that to us for? What does this guy have to say? A troop of the volunteer army just passed by. I wanted to come with them, but defending the city is an important job, too. All we can do is to wait, but we'll pray for the blessings of Bardas. This tavern was crowded with the soldiers in the King's army and volunteer army until recently, but once they left for war, the place became so deserted. I hope they return safely. Yeah, because you want them to buy more drinks from you. It's finally completed. The sacred sword of light that seals in the spirit of Great God. How did you know all this? Says Avin. Not through the grapevine. I can use a spell or two. I feel an extraordinary power from you. It must be the power of Bardas. I agree, Michelle says. I haven't felt such a strong wave before. I feel the same way, Ruti says. Avin says, certainly the sword looks awesome, but I don't feel any divine power. Gawain says that means you need more training. Please, Sage. Diva Diana says, it's a precious gift that he can be so insensitive in front of this power. In a way, he deserves to be the owner of the sacred sword. Haha, you have a point, says Gawain. Avin says, are you complimenting me or teasing me? A joke aside, Diana says, a musician can't play better than what his skills allow him to, just because he has a great instrument. The same applies to swords. Remember, it's up to you to become the user of the sword or just a carrier of it. I know what you say, says Avin. I'll remember that. All I can do is to play my harp and weave my lyrics. Take care. I'm looking forward to welcoming you back with a joyous song. My partner says he wants to join the volunteer army. He hasn't touched a sword in his life. What is he thinking? He's thinking crazy thoughts. We didn't know it was happening. It's not too late. I should go to the guild and enroll myself into the volunteer army. Merchant Barlack says, I get it. It must be the curse of Octum's apostles that caused the arrest of the great oracle and seizure of my treasures. Avin says, can't you see you brought this upon yourself? Nope, cannot see. No seeing. Old man Joy. It may not be possible to end the battle without any casualty, but I can't help but pray. May the blessings of Bardas reach everyone. A Adventurers will become busy if many monsters show up, right? I wonder if Uncle Dick is okay. Lady, that's obscene. Oh, Giamain and... what's his name? Karuna? Karamas. Hi, Avin. Mr. Karamas, have you finished the last episode yet? I did indeed. Giamain has a bound copy. So the series has concluded, says Retis. Congratulations. That's great, says Avin. Good work. Well, thanks. Is he a writer? Asked Michelle. Yes, says Retis. He wrote the popular novel called Swordswoman Safi. Oh, really? I'd love to read it myself. Karamas says, I'll go and take a rest for a while. I must store up stamina before starting my next book. Avin says, besides, it's not easy to keep running away from Giamain. You're perfectly right. He's so persistent, he always manages to find me. I'm more impressed by your footwork, says Retis. They say you've traveled the west and the east. You just slow down, says Avin. You're not young anymore. Can't you just sit still and write? What are you talking about? Safi and Raven are fruits of my physical research. I still have the stamina to run away. Avin says, you should say I still have the stamina to write. I can't believe this. Why am I surrounded by such active old men? Gawain says, Avin, you need more training. You shouldn't be silenced by old men like us. The sage is right. Well, no one's silencing him. Go and find more exciting, thrilling adventures so you can write about it. Yeah, I know. You don't stop, do you? Says Avin. Alright, alright. Avin, says Karamas. Quick Raven was inspired by your adventures. Although the series is finished, the adventures of Raven and his friends are not over yet. It's up to you guys to put a happy ending to the story. Don't forget that. I won't. Now, Giamain? He finally did it, Avin. Quick Raven is finished. Here, Quick Raven, last volume. You'll be moved by the ending. Take time to read it, will you? Quick Raven 9. Avin and the company obtained it. Kudos to you too, Giamain. They always forget to change the text color back after that. Thank you. Giamain says, tears well up just remembering all the pains I had to go through. You'll surely come to tears listening to my story. But everything is over now. All thanks to you guys. I don't know how to thank you. Haha, we haven't done much, says Avin. We did give him ideas, but it was his talent that turned them into exciting stories. You're so humble, Avin, says Giamain. I love you, Avin. I'll return your favor personally. Avin says, your thought is enough. We owe everything to you. I don't know how to thank you. Alright. Alright, so we got the last Quick Raven book. I'm pretty happy about that. How do I get out of here? Okay. We've come full circle. These shop owners aren't going to say anything else. I'm going to just check to see if I have anything else. Anything new. Old Woman Sierra. The paladins must be fighting with their lives in various places of Elfilden. May the blessings of Bardis protect them. Old Man Mayhat. It won't be long before we take back Cathedral. I'll be able to put my son and his wife to rest at last. 8 years. It was a long time. Oh, she's on the... I can't talk to him when she's up on that. She's not on the same... Here we go. Like, ground or whatever. I promised to my grandfather and his friends to visit Cathedral once peace returns. It's the place my father and mother were killed. I can't wait to see an end to this fighting. I'll be cheering you on. Cheering, I tell you, cheering. Alright, so I was gonna check to see if there's anything new. How many? Let me just see what we have. We might need all the help we can get here. Okay, so rarest potion, we need 3. As pure kingdom 3, we need 3. Okay. Attack goes up quite a bit by 30, but defense goes down and avoidance. War title. Magic Warhammer empowered by Spirit Tor causes electric shock upon impact. Still though, it brings that down that other stuff. We give her a Tilfang. Throwing knife with an elephant-shaped handle, blade has the power of nature. Wow. We need another holy iris about for Michelle and Avin. Wait, who's using the holy iris now? Oh, we didn't equip that? Because I died and I just collected it and never equipped it. So I made it easier for him to be damaged. Wonderful. Alright, so we need one more then. For Michelle. Holy Lostrum. Armor blessed by the spirits of past heroes. Looks heavy, but actually light. Alright, we'll take 3. I'm glad I checked. I didn't think he was going to have anything new. He sure does. Who is it that... For Michelle. Yeah. Defense up by 5. Attack up by 12. Tilfang. And then the Lostrum. Defense up by 8. Across the board. Oh, not buy, sell. Sell, sell, sell. Swear blade. Two famed Petricas. And four famed Pleiades. Oh, thank you very much. My husband joined the volunteer army and left for the battleground. I had cried and shouted to change his mind until yesterday, but I couldn't sway his determination. All I could do was say goodbye to him with a smile and pray for him. Is he fighting with dangerous monsters now? Oh, Bardis, answer my prayers. Please spare his life. Yes, horrible ones with sharp, pointy teeth. Why are we going in the... Oh, we have to go this way. It's probably Rutis who's going to say it. Yep. What are we doing in the underground waterway? We're just messing around. Finding a lot of those rebleefs. I don't need them though. A lot of them. Another one? Oh, that's a rare. Well, you got the hookah pipe. Ruru's hair is rising straight up. He rarely gets this scared. My husband is standing by as a reservist in the event the enemy invades us in a large number. I hope it will never happen. I've already polished and tuned my old weapons. Okay, you don't need to tune weapons. If anything happens, I'll join the fight right away. Okay. Keep on tuning those weapons. If the world is destroyed, my business is gone anyway. Come to think of it, I started my business to bring happiness to my family. I guess I've lost sight somewhere along the way. Let's not be greedy to profit from this war. I'll distribute the food in stock to the residents and soldiers free of charge. Of course, it'll be a one-time promotion. Yeah. I changed my opinion of my father. He wasn't only thinking about his business after all. I'm now confident my father will understand why I want to become a scholar. I'll continue to talk to him. Okie doke. Get out of my way. I'll kill you. Help! I'm so busy my head spins. Mountains of food and supplies are arriving from across Elfilden. It's probably the busiest time the dock laborers have ever experienced. Complain too much. It's time for us to show them the honor of the Paladin Army. Bardas, lend us your power. The troops led by General Deeren passed by just a while ago. We must follow the King's army too. Check this door. A drop of water that falls onto the surface of a body of water representing a given era, that's what we call a hero. A hero is a drop of water? A hero exerts influence over people around him, and the influence spreads throughout the world like a ripple effect. Finally, a big wave of energy ushers in a new era. We call this phenomenon a miracle. Okay. You've heard of Ymel, this is Ebel. The paladins told us not to get out of the house unless absolutely necessary. Our child likes to play and never stays home. It's a perfect opportunity to give my baby a lesson. Huh. I'm gonna have a lesson over there? I'm stuck on that thing. I want to join the volunteer army, but Maestro sent me home. It's not fair only adults can fight. You should definitely be thankful. Can I talk to her? Yeah. Talk to everybody? I think, Filden's a little bigger, right? And talk to them. We'll defend the Holy Capital with our lives. If you get tired, you'll have a place to get back to. The elite group of the Paladin Army departed for the battlefield a short while ago. The last battle is finally starting. Now, I think this isn't the way we're supposed to go. Oh, it lets us. Alright. Because I like to see what they say when we try to leave the wrong way. We must take the south exit to get the cathedral, says Avin. We'll put an end to this battle once and for all. There's something over there. Hold on a second. Witi says, Avin, let's head for Cathedral. We must take the south exit to get to the Dio Shrine path. Alright. I think we've talked to everybody. I'm surprised it didn't take me over a half hour. Close, though. Go. There's someone over there. Oh, it's a monster. West is the Dios Shrine Path. As she mentioned. I just want to see what happened. Avin, that's the way to Brazak. We should head for Cathedral. And keep them on course over here. Oops. Just got in a battle there. Dominus Bridge. Seen better days. Up here, chest or anything? No. There it is. I'm back at last, says Avin. When I was here the last time, I painfully learned my powerlessness. Rutis, you saved me then. I wasn't much of a help, she says. But looking back, maybe our journey began at that place in time. Right, says Avin. But it'll be over soon. Avin, take the Eleusion, says Gawain. Yes. The Eleusion, the sacred sword of light empowered by Bardas. Lend us the power to fight the darkness. To reclaim someone important. To answer the prayers of many people. Wow, 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 wow! Whoa. But remember, the light cannot exist without darkness. Michelle says, look, the barrier of darkness is broken. Bardas, I thank you, says Gawain. Avin, we can go now, Rutis says. Yeah, Avin says. It's showtime. Let's go to the cathedral. Nice. Think before we do that, I'm just going to read Quick Raven, the last volume. We'll end off the episode here. So if you guys don't care to hear that, then tune out now. Quick Raven 9, Finding a Hope and a Storm. Karamuro Karamas. Raven ran up to the sorcerer. Maybe? Hope and desperation intersected in his heart. I'll kill him. Kill him. Blood welled up from Dorek's mouth before he finished his sentence. That was the end of the sorcerer. He said he was going to kill Marl. Then, is he alive? Raven looked up to the ceiling as he wiped the blood from his sword. Marl, Raven whispered as he started walking. You're going, aren't you? Rudy asked Raven, who had his back to her. Raven stopped walking. It wasn't a guarantee that Marl was still alive. It could be something made up by the sorcerer. Even if he were alive, it didn't necessarily mean that he could be saved, but... Raven made a decision. I'm going to go look for Marl. As long as he is alive, I'll go to the end of the world to find him. As long as he has the book, the organization would come to Raven. Then perhaps he could find out if Marl was alive or not. He wasn't afraid of having a large organization as his enemy. But why was it that the hand that clutched the book was shaking? Rudy no longer repeated phrases and stood behind Raven. A pleasant wind blew against the two of them, as if to push them forward. It's better to face the storm. Marl's voice rang in Raven's mind. The treasures are always hidden in difficult places. Raven laughed. You're right, Marl. Hope is always hidden in the storm, right? Where will we be going? Rudy asked. Raven pointed into the wind. Where the wind blows to. Where they were heading was undoubtedly towards a storm. But they can't give up. Raven started walking with footsteps of confidence. He was only looking at the hope that lay beyond the storm. Quick, Raven. The end. Wow. It doesn't really end. It kind of ends on a cliffhanger. What the hell, Karamuro? Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.